this. Praise God, presenting His Son to change us all.
Shepherds, shepherds, do not be afraid, for I bring you good news.
Yes.
message, you realize that he changed the world. He created it. He changed it. He changed the way we mark time. But the most important thing that he did was change individual lives. That's why he came. And Paul tells us in the book of Titus that, and now the salvation of God has appeared, speaking of Jesus, bringing salvation to all men. And so, apart from this baby who came to change us, if we don't have him, we don't have salvation. Not only that, but Paul goes on to say that even for those who are believers, it is our reliance upon him on a daily basis that changes us and molds us into his character and fits us someday for glory. And then Paul concludes that passage of Scripture by saying that we are looking for the blessed hope of his appearing. And if you're not changed by the baby, then you don't have the blessed hope of his appearing. So it's all in Christ. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That's why he came, and that's why he died. And that's why he rose from the dead. He asked Peter, when people were debating about who he was and what he was about, he said, who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you're the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of the living God. So, if you come here tonight, and I have no doubt that you know all about Jesus, and I don't see how very many people, at least in the United States, could know all about him. Obviously, you're here tonight, even to come to be a part of a Christian celebration of his birth. But the moment of change comes when, by an act of your will, you submit yourself to his lordship, expressing your faith in him as the one who came to change you. And there's a willingness. A lot of times people don't like to change. They don't want to change. But God commands that we change. And in order to be reconciled to him, Christ is through his Son. So our prayer and the whole reason for the presentation is to bring glory to this baby who came to change us. If you're one of those who have not been addressed, who's not received Jesus Christ as Lord, as I said just a moment ago, it's by faith. And the means whereby you do that is through prayer. You just go to God and tell him that you turn away from your way of doing things, and by faith you receive Christ and you now want to do it his way. I would strongly encourage you to do that, maybe even tonight, before we leave this place. And when the tree is over with, questions still on your mind regarding that, I'll be down here at the front on this stage. I'll be more than happy to visit with any of you who might come. As a conclusion of our celebration of Christ's birth tonight, we want to ask you as the audience to stand, if you would, and join us in singing that great Christmas carol, the hymn of the faith, O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Let's sing together, shall we?
O Come.